Good morning. Please be seated. Thank you for having me again in Charles for singing. Merry Christmas, soon to be Happy New Year. This morning I'll be reading from the New Testament from Luke chapter 2, verses 22 to 40. Listen for the word of God. When the time came for their purification according to the law of Moses, they brought him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male shall be designated as holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples. A light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people, Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for falling and the rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that was opposed, so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was also a prophet Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was of great age, having lived with her husband for 70 years after her marriage, then as a widow to the age of 84. She never left the temple, but she worshiped there fasting and prayer night and day. And at that moment, she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had finished everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
As I read the scripture many times over, I wasn't sure where I was being led to have these very specific words said. First and foremost, Charles and I were on our way here, and he said it sounded like you were speaking about the birth of Jesus. And I said, yeah, that's kind of thought of the scripture, but it's past the birth and on to the next. Many people with the new year like to bring in new ideas and to start preaching and totally dismissing what was said here. The most important things to me were the law of the Lord, and of all the different ceremonies that happened after Jesus was born. The hustle and bustle is coming to an end. Some people have already taken down Christmas, packed it away, time for a new year, time to move on. But here on New Year's Eve, 2023, I know I ask myself, where has the year gone? But as the more I age, I don't say year, I say years. With our new year comes diets, exercise, some of us trying to stop some bad habits, and then some of us trying to bring on good new habits. But what I want us all here today, online and listening, I want us to keep up this good habit, where we come together in worship in a community of faith, sharing Christ's light and hope with one another hand in hand, because God is with us. This first Sunday after Christmas, we hear in our scripture, "Merry Christmas, the Christ child is born." And as we read the scripture this morning, there were many rituals discussed upon the birth of Jesus. After Mary gave birth, one thing of a ritual that they did was Mary and Joseph traveled to present Jesus to God at the temple, because that was a ritual of purification. Mary and Joseph were committed and devout in their faith. And at the temple, they presented an offering to God, two turtle doves. Didn't know how many knew this, but you were actually to present a lamb. But they could not afford to present a lamb. Instead, they offered what they could afford to God, and that was two turtle doves. And although they were near poverty, they kept their religious beliefs and rituals their primary focus in their lives. Mary and Joseph presented their child and honored their faith commitment and their blessing upon their special child. Jesus, the Messiah, is born as God's agent of salvation, to worship God. And with this came peace and hope on the birth of Jesus. God is with us. And as Mary and Joseph arrived to the temple, they were greeted by Simeon and Anna, who were there to follow the law of the Lord. The Holy Spirit rested on Simeon to see the Lord's Messiah before his death. Simeon was an older man. But Simeon fulfilled his lifelong calling to hold the Christ child before his death and being blessed upon his birth. Simeon was like some of us after a child's birth is brought into church for the first time. We run to the new infant and ask the parents, may we hold him? But nowadays, that's changed. You know, COVID, the flu, everybody being sick. I don't know if you can hear, but I got a little bit myself. We tend to be more cautious. But when we have a birth in the church or an acceptance of a new member, the church comes together as witnesses to offer God's peace and hope through support, encouragement, and love to these new people on their faith journeys. Some of us may be like Simeon and step up and be devoted to speaking to Mary and Joseph to tell them what they can expect in the future of Jesus. Then there may be some of us who are more reserved and behind the scenes per se. We remain quiet, but that does not mean we don't support them from a distance. We still offer support, hope, and encouragement, and love, but from afar, because God is with us. But just as Simeon came forward, so did Anna. Anna never left the temple. She was devout in praying and fasting until the Holy Spirit came upon her for the redemption of Israel through the birth of Jesus. Anna told Mary and Joseph of the many witnesses who came for them, the commitment of all the witnesses who showed Jesus, Mary, and Joseph the hope and peace God intends them to have. Anna and Simeon praised God for the Messiah's child. They spoke to all who would listen for the redemption of Jerusalem, and all of them witnessed the peace on earth through the birth of Jesus at the ceremony held at the temple. What do we do today as family traditions, ceremonies, or rituals when there is a new baby? For the family traditions, some families gather together at the hospital in the anticipation of the birth. I must say here that I have a very large family, and they were all there for the birth of my son. I think they were very glad when all of my family left because we were such a large group, but they were all present. Some of us cook meals for our family members, and some of us take flowers and gifts to the hospital and hold that newborn child. What do we do today as our religious traditions or rituals? I'm not sure about this church, but I do know in Beckley that we present a basket to the family and the new baby. We also place a rose in a vase on the communion table to honor that newborn child. And of course, the church prays for that family and new baby. And then what do we do as social traditions? I must say this is where I had a hard time because I didn't do a lot of social traditions when my children were born. I know that there are parties for babies and parents, and I know there's announcements that are sent out. But what traditions do we commit to more than others? Where do we place our emphasis? In our family traditions, in our religious traditions, or our social traditions? It is a miracle and a blessing to have a child. And it is our commitment as witnesses to raise that child in the faith of Christ, to share our faith, to help and support and love a child in their faith. We commit ourselves to carry on our faith journeys to show peace and hope to all people of God. Just as written in our scripture this morning, the birth of Jesus is hope and peace for all people. God is with us. So let us keep our religious traditions. We do not have to wait for a birth because we are all children of God who share peace and hope with one another. We share peace with those who are unsure of their futures. We are committed Christians to God who walk in harmony, hand in hand, with peace and hope. To give a child your hand and heart is to listen and to care. We are all children of God. Age doesn't matter, but your heart and your hand do. So let us reach out to one another. Maybe just reach out to one person this week and show them compassion. Let them know they are a child of God and that you are there to listen and to care. It can be as easy as a card. Go visit someone, as long as you're not sick, in person, or it can be as simple as a phone call. The peace and hope in Jesus' birth has brought us to lovingly extend that peace and hope to one another because God is with us. The scripture reading has committed witnesses coming together to commit themselves to God, to come together and support and love the Christ child, to follow the law of the Lord. We are a community of faith to support and love. There is hope and peace when we share the good news and show compassion to care for all people of God. There is no age limit. And we share Christ's light and dedicate time to care for every child brought into the church. There are times when we may not be our blood relatives, but they are a child to share the good news and encourage them on their faith journey. But wait a minute. Aren't we all actually blood relatives? Aren't all of us sitting in the church today and listening, children of God, given hope and peace to carry out the commitment of God's love through the birth of Jesus Christ? Jesus' birth has brought peace and joy into our lives, not just today, and not just on Jesus' birth, but every day of our lives. God's constant love will deepen our understanding of the gospel and strengthen our commitment to follow the way of Christ with peace and hope, because God is with us. Simeon spoke to Mary in a way she was not expecting, to hear the words, "She will have a sword piercing her own soul." Of course, he says this figuratively, but he explains to Mary that Jesus will face many trials in his life. And Simeon predicts that Jesus will fall and rise in his life. His life was devoted to spreading the good news and caring for all God's children, again, no matter their age. Jesus did fall. Jesus did have many trials and tribulations. But he rose again. And God sent his only son to be an example to all of us, to be like Simeon and Anna, and devote our lives to God and be led by the Holy Spirit, to fulfill our calling for Christ, to dedicate our lives together to worship God hand in hand and in peace and hope. God is with us. Let us pray. In you, O God, we will greatly rejoice knowing you are with us. In speaking, we will greatly rejoice. In silence, we will greatly rejoice. In travels, we will greatly rejoice. In resting, we will greatly rejoice. And in working, we will greatly rejoice. O God, our whole being exults in you, and our lives shall evermore declare your praise, our peace, our hope, our joy. Amen.